The Earth and the Moon, a tale as old as time. We know that the Earth has a natural satellite called the Moon that orbits around our planet. Don't believe me? Look up at the sky. Scientists think that the Moon formed around 4.5 billion years ago, when the early Earth, known as Gaia, collided with another planet. This collision caused a piece of our planet to break off, eventually forming the Moon, which now orbits our planet. But what if it were the other way around? What if the Earth orbited the Moon? That is the question we are asking right now on Life's Biggest Questions. Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions. I'm Charlotte Dobre. On this channel, we question anything and everything and compile our answers into short videos for your entertainment. Hit that subscribe for more daily head scratchers and don't forget to stick around until the end of the video where we respond to users' comments. There are two ways in which it could be possible for the Earth to orbit the Moon. The first, the Earth would have to be far less massive than the Moon. The Moon weighs about 80 times less than the Earth. The Moon's diameter is 2,159 miles, about one quarter the size of the Earth's. So the Earth would have to be smaller than a quarter of its current size for it to be pulled in by the Moon's gravity and be locked into its orbit. Either that, or the Moon would have to be much bigger than the Earth. For simplicity's sake, let's choose the second option. If the Earth orbited the Moon, then that would make our Earth a Moon and the Moon a planet. From Earth, the Moon would look gigantic. It would take up a huge portion of the sky. If the Earth orbited the Moon, that would mean that from Earth, we would be able to see the dark side of the Moon. As it stands, we do not see the dark side of the Moon, known as the far side of the Moon. The far side of the Moon is technically not the dark side of the Moon because it's not always dark. When the Moon is between the Earth and the Sun, during the new moon phase, that is when the back side of the Moon is bathed in sunlight, but we don't see it. If the Earth were orbiting the Moon, we would definitely be able to see what's on the other side of it. My guess is it looks a whole lot like the visible side of the Moon. Who knows, maybe there's an ancient civilization on the far side of the Moon, but that's highly unlikely. The question is, would life still exist if Earth were smaller than the Moon? Considering how much the Moon affects our planet already, even though it's only 27% the size of the Earth, the chances of life existing as we know it on Earth would be very slim. Just like how the Earth's gravitational pull affects the Moon's gravitational pull affects us. Other than the tides, our Moon actually prevents the Earth from wobbling on its axis. Mars wobbles around on its axis quite a lot, likely because it has two very small moons that don't have very much of a gravitational impact on it. The tilt of the Earth would be even more stable if the Earth orbited the Moon. Experts think that if our Moon was far bigger, it wouldn't have much of an effect on the stability of the Earth. It would likely even make the climate on Earth far more stable. Ice ages might happen far less often. The entire history of our planet might be different. Humans might not have advanced to what they are now because experts believe that the Ice Age is what forced humans to implement agriculture. If the Earth orbited the Moon, it would mean that an average day on Earth would be much longer. Scientists know this from looking at other planets. Pluto, for example, has a moon that's almost half its size, Charon. Pluto and Charon are tidally locked onto each other. They spin around together. If the Earth orbited the Moon, that could quite possibly mean that the Earth would be tidally locked onto the Moon. All of the Earth would still get sunlight, but the amount of time that parts of the Earth got sunlight would definitely change. Imagine an entire side of Earth not getting sunlight for weeks at a time. That would make it pretty difficult for life to exist as we know it. It should be noted that there are areas of Earth that don't get sunlight for extended periods of time, like the Arctic Circle. Life and humans still exist in the Arctic Circle even without the Sun for 6 months at a time. Still though, an Earth that's actually a Moon orbiting the Moon would definitely be a strange place to live. I think I'd like to keep things the way they are for the time being. What about you? Why don't you let me know down in the comments? For now, I'm going to respond to some comments from my last video on this channel. What if our Sun hit another star? Mr. Brian the Hedgehog said, "What if Kirby was real? I would definitely want to hug him. Kirby looks quite huggable, don't you agree?" Batman Fan Forever said, "What if we had a hotel in space?" Well, funny you ask that. That idea has already been thought of. It's called the Aurora Station. It's the first luxury space hotel, and in 2 short years, you will be able to go to space for a vacation. Oh, but it also costs $9.5 million, but I mean, that's to be expected. Clay Talman said, "What if Charlotte Dobre showed herself on these videos?" Well, if you want to see what I look like, I host another channel called Inform Overload. We do the news and we make it entertaining. So if you want to see my face, definitely head on over to Inform Overload. That one guy said, "Yay, more space videos. I love when y'all do space videos." So do I, that one guy. So do I. That is all for this video and thank you for watching. If you want to keep watching, check out the playlist that is currently flashing on your screen. And don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, and turn on notifications, and I will see you in a future episode of Life's Biggest Questions.